What's crackin', creator? Are you ready to boogie down? Great, because in this tutorial, you'll learn how to leverage the music you create with the Fortnite Patchwork suite of devices to create a music-based game. Meaning, your music will be the star of the show, controlling different gameplay mechanics. To learn more about Patchwork, check out the documentation online or jump into the Patchwork Music Gallery Island, which includes a step-by-step tutorial. The system you'll learn connects a song created with Patchwork to different Fortnite and Verse devices. Like in this post-apocalyptic discotheque whose dilapidated dance floor is all that stands between you and safety. The dancing lights grooving to the music actually change color based on the beat of the song. So you'll need to keep your eyes on them because if the color of the tile you're on doesn't match the color of the lights, you'll take damage. But before you can set up the gameplay, grab your dancing shoes because it's time to make some music. There are a lot of Patchwork devices. To find them in UEFN, search Patchwork in the Fortnite folder, then drag the devices you want out into the world as normal. Here's where things are a little different. Unlike other Fortnite devices, the Patchwork device needs to be adjusted during a live edit session. You can place the devices down in UEFN or go straight into a live edit session and drag the devices out from the creative inventory. To get this disco beat going, let's start with some drums. When near the drum sequencer, you'll get a Patchwork tool to use to edit the devices. While the drum sequencer has some great presets, this post-apocalisco will be getting its own original composition. Each of the colored shapes on the device represent a different part of the percussion you can use to make your beat. You can cycle through your creation using the page wheel. Be sure the auto button is turned on so the device automatically scrolls through each page as your song loops. Putting those all together, here's what this song's percussion sounds like. Moving on to the drum player, you can adjust the volume, tune, and shape knobs to customize your kit even further. With the beat in place, it's time to fill out the rest of the song. Far out! Feel free to experiment with your own song using all Patchwork has to offer. Now, let's set up the connection that's used to link the song to the game. The note trigger device is the key player here. UEFN devices can't listen to the song while it's playing, so they don't know when to activate based on the song. But the note trigger device can listen. It lies in wait, and when it hears a target instrument or note, it sends out a signal any device can pick up on, acting as the bridge between Patchwork and any other device. In this game, it's waiting until it hears this. When that sound on the drum sequencer is heard, the note trigger device signals all the devices waiting for it, which can even include a custom Verse device, and with Verse, pretty much anything is possible. But you don't have to use the drum sequencer. Any instrument can be used to cue the note trigger and make some gameplay, so go wild! Now, let's look at the dance floor. This colorful disco is made up of glass floor tiles which have a unique look and property that lets you change their color. Damage volumes go over each tile and, depending on the color of the lights, get disabled to make certain tiles safe or are activated to damage players on the wrong tile. Make sure your damage volume settings match what's on screen. Speaking of lights, let's take a look at them. This level uses concert lights that move to the beat, shining over the dance floor, letting players know what color tile is safe. Place these lights all around and make sure the settings match what's on the screen. These lights will be blue, but you'll need a set of lights for each color, so make a folder for the blue lights and place them all inside. Then, selecting all of the lights and the folder, duplicate and rename the new folder to a new color. Select all of the new lights, change their color to the new one, and importantly, turn these lights off. Repeat this step, keeping the new lights off for each color tile you have. You should end up with only the blue lights shining in the editor. Now, you need two trigger devices per color. Call them Activate Color and Disable Color. You should also turn off the visual and sound effects for all these triggers so your song is the only thing players hear. Assign the Activate Color triggers to the Turn On option of the respective colored lights and the Disable Color triggers to the Turn Off option. Grab one more trigger device and call it Change Colors. This will be the device that waits for the note trigger device's signal, and you'll monitor the Change Colors trigger through a custom Verse device. Make sure that trigger is set up as shown, connected to the note trigger. Then create two new Verse devices, one called Color Manager and the other Light Controller. The Color Manager script uses something called Gameplay Tags, which will let you assign a tag to creative objects, such as a device or prop in your island. When tagged, you can find and reference that creative object in the code, which, in this case, will be how you tell what damage volume to activate or disable for each color. Color Manager is also an abstract class, meaning it's not being used like a normal Verse device. Instead, this class will be the base, with properties that each color will need, like an activation and deactivation trigger, a function to set the color to be safe, and more. It also needs to be abstract because the tag class itself is abstract. To learn more about classes and subclasses like an abstract class and their benefits, check out the documentation online. Back in the Color Manager script, as mentioned before, each color has an activation and deactivation trigger. It also has a tag associated with it and a delay for when a color goes from being safe to unsafe so players can get a chance to react. The variable devices of this color will store every device with an assigned tag when the setup function is run. SetSafe is an asynchronous function that, when called, disables every damage volume with the color's tag and activates the color's lights, setting the color as safe in the game. SetUnsafe is also an asynchronous function, but this one disables the lights associated with a color, then waits a bit to give players time to react before enabling the damage volumes associated with the color. Here's where the fun starts. As mentioned, Color Manager is an abstract class, meaning you can implement its functionality for each color by creating a subclass. For example, Red Color Manager implements all of what you just saw from the Color Manager class, like the SetSafe and SetUnsafe functions, but it also assigns the tag to be red. Blue's Color Manager, on the other hand, assigns the tag to be blue. What this means is if you call the SetSafe function from the Red Color Manager, it will turn on the red lights and disable any damage volumes tagged with red, meaning they are over a red tile. If you call the SetUnsafe function from the Blue Color Manager, it will make sure the blue lights are off and enable any damage volumes on a blue tile. Another great thing about this setup is that you can add different functionality to each color as you get more advanced, like creating a function for red tiles that causes them to flicker visibility. So, create a subclass for each color in your game. To actually use gameplay tags, you need to create them at the bottom of the script like so. The first part of each line is the name of the tag. With the Color Manager script complete, head back into the editor and build your Verse code. Great! Let's assign some tags to damage volumes. Click on one of the damage volumes over a blue tile. Then, in the Details window, click the Add button to add a component and select Verse Tag Markup. Choose the blue tag to tag the volume. In the Component view, copy the Verse Tag Markup component and paste this onto each damage volume on a blue tile. Next, copy this component onto a damage volume over a different color tile. Change the tag to be the proper one, and repeat until every damage volume is tagged with the color of the tile it's on top of. Now, let's move on to the Light Controller Verse device. This device needs to reference each color's color manager, and they are editable references, so you can change the variables associated with them in the editor. You'll also need an array for all the color managers, an editable trigger device variable for the change colors trigger, and an integer that stores the current safe color. Before moving on, build your Verse code and drag out the device. Take a look at the Details window. You can see you now have a dropdown for each color's color manager, and in that dropdown are the activation and deactivation devices ready to be assigned. Assign all the proper devices like so and head back to the script. In the OnBegin function, assign each color manager to the color manager's array, then call the setup function from color manager to cache the damage volumes assigned to each tag. Next, subscribe a new function, onChangeColors, to the triggered event of the changeColors trigger. Before creating onChangeColors, make the function getNextColors, which is failable and has the transacts and decides specifiers. This creates an array with all colors except for the currently active one, then picks a random color from these options. Now, create onChangeColors. In an if expression, generate a new safe color using the getNextColor function you just made and get a reference to the new color's color manager. Set the current color to the new safe color, then spawn the new safe color SetSafe function, which will disable the proper damage volumes and turn on the correct lights. For every other color, spawn the SetUnsafe function, which makes sure that every other light is disabled and the damage volumes are ready to take out anyone on the wrong color tile. Back in the editor, build your Verse code once more, and you're all set. If you ever want to add another color, all you have to do is create a new subclass and tag for it in the Color Manager script. Then, in the Light Controller script, add a reference to the new color manager, add it to the color manager's array in OnBegin, and set up the devices, lights, and tiles in-game. And with that, you should have a game all set up, with a gameplay mechanic connected to your Patchwork song. Remember, you can use the system for tons of other mechanics, just make sure to listen for the note trigger signal. If you like the look of this experience, check out the finished version with the island code on screen. Catch you on the flip side, and keep creating!